for your patience in this program. Paul Sunkari is the pastor of Indian Christian Church of Sacramento. God has called him 3 years ago to start this church. And Pastor Paul, along with Sister Hepsi, live here in Folsom with their two sons, Daniel and Jonathan. Daniel has just moved to Long Beach to pursue his bachelor's, but we are glad that Daniel is here with us today. So welcome back, Daniel. So there he is. But just want to say that it's actually a real blessing to have Pastor Paul with us, and we really admire his devotion and his hunger to do God's work, and you know, it has inspired many of us over here. So now I invite Pastor Paul to come over here and share with us the good news of Easter message. So let's all welcome him. Thanks.
Thank you, Sandra. Hope you all have enjoyed the kids program and the skit. And I just want to thank you all for coming this evening. It's a great joyous occasion to celebrate the Resurrection Day. The whole world is celebrating the Resurrection Day today. And you know, I want to wish you a happy Easter today. And it is the Resurrection Day. You know, it is the day when Jesus died and rose again. He died on a Good Friday, and then after 3 days, on Easter Sunday morning, he rose again. And they say, you know, you cannot escape two things. That is taxes and death. You know, a lot of people might evade taxes, but nobody can escape death. Death is ultimate and 100% sure that everybody who ever comes into this world will die one day. And, you know, but when we think about resurrection or the Easter, we know that death is defeated, and that's a miracle. Jesus rose again. That's why we celebrate today. To understand that Jesus rose again, we should know that Jesus died first. He was dead. Some people think Jesus was not dead. He was hanging on the cross, and then he felt unconscious, and then they put him in the cave, and he came out because he came to his consciousness and he came out. But if you think of it, the punishment Jesus went through, the Roman punishment, the punishment under Roman governor, it was a horrible punishment. First of all, they took off his clothes, they put a crown of thorns on his head, and they pressed the thorns so that the deep thorns will go inside his head. And they whipped him, you know, Roman scourge that has metal balls and pieces of metal and bones at the end. So when they whip, the flesh came out. I'm sure you might have seen the Passion of Christ movie. That was what happened to Jesus. And he was disfigured. He did not eat anything from the day before till that day evening. And he had to carry a heavy cross on top of the mountain, and he was nailed to the cross, hung there for 3 hours, gasping for breath. And Roman soldiers, they will never leave the person, person alive on the cross. They come and they break your legs if you are still alive on the cross. So when they came to Jesus, they saw that he was dead. How did they know that Jesus was dead? They took a spear, and they thrusted the spear in his side. And then the Bible says, water and blood came out of that wound. The reason is there was something called pericardium, a sac around your heart, and the water will be formed in that pericardium when you are dead. So that's how they knew that, you know, when the water comes out of that wound, he's dead. So Jesus was dead, and he was buried, not like buried under the earth, but he was put in a cave. That's how the Jews, they bury the dead. There was a cave belonging to a person called Joseph of Arimathea. He's from a village called Arimathea. He was a wealthy man, and he had a tomb in that cave. So he brought Jesus, he wrapped him, and then put him in that tomb. Now, we know that Jesus rose again. What were the proofs for Jesus rose again on the third day? The empty tomb is the greatest proof. Because, you know, on that Sunday morning, Mary Magdalene and there were other women, they went to the tomb because they wanted to wrap Jesus' body with more perfume. And when they went there, this huge rock that was covering the mouth of the tomb, it was rolled away. There was an angel sitting there, and the angel told them that he is risen. He's not here, he's already risen. And then these women went and they told the disciples. They also went and they saw. So the empty tomb is still there today, showing that Jesus is no more dead, he is alive. And then, not only the tomb was empty, he appeared to many people, the eyewitnesses. Jesus appeared to at least 12 different occasions that was recorded in the Bible. And he appeared to Mary Magdalene, and he appeared to his own disciples. He appeared to Peter, and he appeared to 7 disciples. And he appeared to 500 people on one occasion. You know, you can fool 1 or 2 people, but you cannot fool 500 people. So it was very clear that Jesus rose again, and he appeared to all these people. He also gave convincing proofs. He ate with them, and he told Thomas, "Come and put your fingers in my nail marks." That's how he was giving complete proof that he was alive. The same Jesus who lived with them, he was alive. And the third proof we have is the changed lives. These disciples, they were discouraged, they were depressed. You know, Peter, he lied that I have no association with this man. And all of them, they deserted Jesus when he went onto the cross. They all left him because they were afraid. They were hiding. And, you know, they didn't have any hope. They didn't know what to do. And then Jesus came. He showed himself to them. You look at their lives after that, total change. They gave their lives for Jesus. They became martyrs. And not only the disciples, even today, people are getting martyred because of their faith. It's because they have experienced the risen Lord. Jesus Christ is alive, and he is changing the lives of people today. Now, it happened 2,000 years ago. How is it relevant to us today? You know, you might think, you know, whatever had happened, happened. He came, he died, he rose again. So what has it got to do with me today? You know, resurrection proves that Jesus is God. That's the first thing. Because human beings, they don't die and just rise up again. Because as I said, 100% sure that every person will die. And people, once they die, they go. I mean, they don't come back to life. But only God has authority over life and death. That's why Jesus was born to a virgin. And he rose again from the dead. So he has authority over life and death. So he is God himself, came in the form of a man into this world. C.S. Lewis, great writer, he writes in a book called Mere Christianity, no mere man, not alone a great religious leader, could have said and done the things that Jesus did. The only options are that Jesus is a liar or a lunatic or Lord of all. And he is a former atheist, C.S. Lewis. He became convinced that Jesus is the Lord. You know, why did Jesus have to come, die, and go through that horrible crucifixion and again rise again? You know, if you think of it, every religion teaches this. God is holy. And God is up there in heaven. And we cannot really approach God. We are sinners. All human beings have this sinful nature. We might not commit the acts of sin, but in our thoughts, in our actions, we might commit sin. So this sin is preventing us from reaching God. So there's a relationship. When God created human beings, he created in his image, in his likeness, but that relationship is broken when man fell into sin. And this sin has been passed down to all of us, to entire human beings, entire human race. But in order for man to reach God, the only way he can reach God is to become holy. And that's not possible for a man, because Bible says the wages of sin is death. So if man has to atone for his own sin, every person will have to die. That's why the merciful, loving God, he sent his own son into this world. He came, he died that merciless death on the cross. The hard, bitter death on the cross. And he rose again. And Jesus rising from the dead vindicates that God accepted his sacrifice on the cross. And now we don't have to die. We just have to believe that Jesus died for us, he rose again, and just accept him as your Savior. And then he will come into your heart. You know, if only we realize that we all have sin, and that can only go away when we believe that Jesus died for our sins and he rose again. And his resurrection also guarantees our resurrection. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and life. The one who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. You know, we will leave this world one day, but we will live forever in one place, whether it is heaven or hell. It's very clear. Bible is very clear about that. So the choice we make today, here, will determine the destiny we have, whether we spend eternity with God, in his fellowship with him, or we spend eternity away from him, totally ruined and destroyed. It's our choice. It was in June 18, 1815, the Battle of Waterloo. The French, under the command of Napoleon, were fighting the Allies under the command of Wellington. The people of England depended on a system of semaphore signals to find out how the battle was going. One of those signals read on that day, and it was all foggy that day, and it say that the signal flashed saying Wellington defeated. Just in those moments, because of the fog covered, they couldn't read anymore. Wellington defeated. And the news quickly spread, and the whole country was sad and gloomy when they heard this news that their country lost the war. And suddenly the fog lifted, the remainder of the message appeared, and it was not two words, it was four words. Wellington defeated the enemy. Wellington defeated the enemy. those last two words make all the sense, because it changed from defeat to victory. That's what happened on Christmas, on Easter Day. On Good Friday, Jesus died. People thought everything is gone. I mean, we thought Jesus will become a king. He will ruin. He will reign on this on Roman government, and he will become a king. But he was crucified. He was dead. They lost all the hope. All the disciples were hiding because they lost all their hope. But on the Easter day, just like how Wellington defeated the enemy, on Easter day, Jesus defeated the death. Bible says, death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? Death has no power over humankind, because Jesus came, took away the death. And if you know that Jesus defeated the enemy, Satan, and death, you will live a victorious life. You don't have to worry. You don't have to live in guiltiness. You don't have to live in that sin and shame. Jesus will take away all that shame. He will take away all that guilt. He will take away all our sins, and he will give you the eternal life. Do you want this eternal life today? This is the message of Easter. Jesus is offering on this resurrection day. He rose again to give us the eternal life. And it will be yours if you accept him. And, you know, may this resurrection life, a life of peace, satisfaction, tolerance, and joy, will be yours today. And Jesus is risen. He's risen indeed. Thank you.